everybody, welcome back. This is episode 11, which is going out as soon as this finished recording. Normally it goes on Tuesday, and we're recording on this lovely Tuesday, so we're going to continue from where we left up. Hope you all are enjoying it, and like always, if you all remember to hit that subscribe button and hit that bell notification so you know when your number one goes live. And as always, if you want to watch me live, I'm live pretty much every day on Twitch. Same handle, it's linked. In fact, later on today, you can catch me live on Twitch. Some Genshin tonight. I want to see y'all ugly folks there. Stop on by, say hello.
Okay, I've got 2 hours to kill. A shower would be fucking amazing.
Alright, so, we go over there.
Is that David's towel? Where the hell is mine? Okay, my towel's probably in here somewhere. No awesome pirate towel. Lots of washcloths. No towel. David really is moving in. So, if I put this photo out, Mom just hides it in a different drawer? What the hell?
Okay, so is that in your mother's room?
Mom usually does my laundry when she gets sick of me not doing my laundry. Maybe she believed me for once about never coming back home.
Where's this towel?
I believe Max and I were so into this shit when we were kids. Wait a minute. Captain Bluebeard's hair dye. Max was going to make me a pirate, but we never got around to it. Ready for the best shower of my life.
Thank you.
I need new clothes. What do I feel like wearing on this crazy ass day?
Illuminati Deluxe, maybe. Oh, yeah.
Alright. One last thing. I need to get Dad's tools so I can fix that truck. Dad's toolbox should be in the garage downstairs. Here goes. What are the chances I can avoid Mom and David?
I'm flipping them over.
Not yet. I told you. 3 minutes each side.
They're gonna burn.
Oh, you're the expert now.
I can't stand it.
I'm telling you, it'll make a mess. You know, you don't have to make me breakfast. I'd settle for flowers.
You cook all the time. I want you to have a break at home.
You are one class act, David Madsen.
Huh. Mom actually looks pretty happy right now.
Hey, who's there?
Hey.
Chloe, your hair. When did... was this for the play? I heard you performed last night.
Nope. I mean, I did. But this is something different.
None of that matters now. Oh, I am so glad to see you.
Good to see you, Chloe. Coming home was a smart decision.
Sure doesn't seem like home. There's someone else's shit all over the bathroom.
Well, we've always talked about needing a bigger bathroom, haven't we?
Sorry, Mom. Just forget I said anything. I'm not staying long, anyway. Just here to pick up something.
Are you coming home tonight?
Mom, I don't know.
I wish you would tell me what you're up to.
I'm just hanging out with Rachel.
Oh, how is Rachel? I was telling David about the play and you being in it.
I really gotta go.
Listen, wait. Before you go, David has something to say to you.
Oh, great.
It won't take but a minute.
Mom.
I don't think this is the best idea.
You already promised.
Chloe, I've made an agreement with your mother to trust you from now on.
Really? What does that mean?
It means that from today forward, I'm going to take you at your word. So, if you say you haven't been smoking or drinking, then I'll just leave you be. Even though she had pot yesterday.
David, the idea is you should feel comfortable here, Chloe. David's not going to question you, and neither am I.
David's lying to your face, Mom. He searched my room.
What?
You didn't know? Detective Dickwad here went through all of my drawers and my bed.
It's what you asked me to do. Make sure she's got no drugs or alcohol for her own good.
Oh, my goodness, Chloe. I'm sorry.
I thought that... I'm sorry, Joyce. I didn't know this would upset
you.
It's
Chloe who deserves the apology.
Well, Chloe, I'm sorry that I violated your privacy. I did it with your best interest in mind.
Okay. I accept your lame apology.
Chloe.
What? I really meant it. Good job. Can we be done now?
Wait, one second. Don't go, Chloe. I've been meaning to show you something. Maybe now's a good time. This is my friend Phil Becker. We served in the same unit. Two tours. Becker was killed near the end of our deployment. Roadside IED. We used to joke about all the trouble we were gonna get into once we got back home. But he died. He died, and I didn't. And I think about that fact every damn day. The point is, I've had my share of grief. I know what you're going through. So I guess what I'm saying is, I'm here to do whatever I can to help you get over the loss of your dad.
Please, I'm begging you. Give David a chance, won't you?
Here. Why don't you keep this photo for a little while? Think about what I've said.
David looks so young. And this Phil guy, they look close. Thank you, David.
Oh, Chloe.
Mom.
I'm just so proud of you both.
Mom, I really need to go.
Be careful out there, Chloe.
I love you, sweetheart.
All right, all right. What the hell? Just gotta grab Dad's toolbox and then get out of here quick. Holy crap. This might actually be helpful for fixing up the truck. Come on. Work with me here. Better, but still needs a bit more love. I can salvage this beast. I just need to find the right tool for each problem. Pretty loose. How can I tighten it? Much better. This thing is gunked the fuck up. I can definitely see some problems. This thing seems pretty gunked up. I think I should move on to something else. The distributor cap looks pretty gross. I need something small to scrape the gunk off the cap. That should help keep shit distributed. Well, fuck. Go back from whence you came. Maybe. Sick. What do I see? I know.
Nice.
Looks like someone tried to patch this thing up sometime before I was born. At this point, I think that ancient duct tape is better than anything I can do. Better leave it be. This connection is pretty shaky. I could fix this battery post if I could get a good enough grip on it. There. Fits like a deadly electric glove. Spark plugs busted. Carbon deposits. Of course. Please, I need you.
Yeah. Junkyard Queen, where are you at?
Huh? Hey.
Holy shit. Your hair. It's so...
badass.
I was gonna say hot. But, yeah, badass too. Hey, not sure if you saw, but someone moved your truck.
No way.
Should we check it out?
Hey, Price. Nice wheels.
You're early, Frank. What's the occasion?
It's his fucking bar mitzvah. Frank here's becoming a man. Aren't you, big guy?
What's he doing here?
Hey, I thought we were cool after that Drew North thing. Don't you want to be cool?
I just want to talk to Frank. As long as you don't get in the way, we'll be fine.
I told you. She's like this.
Gotta say, I really dig the whole tough girl thing. Frank was right about you. How'd you like to work full time for us?
Don't fucking touch her.
Why is it that chicks think it's okay to hit me? But if I lay a single finger on them, suddenly it's a whole other thing. Frank says you were asking about a client of his. That true?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's true. I don't see why you should give a shit.
You don't? Huh. Maybe I'll show you. See, you two Nancy Drews decided it would be a good idea to call your drug dealer and ask about his business. I didn't go to a fancy academy, but that doesn't strike me as smart. Maybe it was this man's sunny disposition that confused you, but he's got a whole other side to him that I don't think you'd like. Should we let them see it?
We're just talking here.
Okay, then let's talk. I want to know right now. Why you give a shit about this woman?
Why do you care so much?
Because... fuck you. I'm asking the questions here.
Look, none of this matters. All we care about is that you stop asking questions. Got it?
No. Tell me where she is, now.
Rachel.
Wait a minute. No way.
What the fuck is your problem?
Rachel? As in, Rachel Amber? That makes so much sense. This is James Amber's fucking kid.
Damon.
Your dad's a real piece of shit, you know?
We're aware. Not sure what that has to do with us.
Me neither. But I'd like to find out. Here's what happens next.
Come on, man. They're just kids.
No, they're not. This one is the fucking DA's daughter. And right now, she's going to fill me in on what her daddy is up to. and how he's connected to that whore everyone's asking about.
Damon, calm down. We're still talking. Everything's still cool. No need to get crazy.
You fucking bitch!
What the hell? I want to say this is going to be the end of this episode. I don't know. I'm glad to go to another save point. I'm going to have to get to another save point.
Rachel is going to be all right. The knife damaged her brachial artery, but didn't cut it. She's out of surgery, and now she's resting. Chloe, what happened?
I don't know. Everything happened so fast. Do you know who Damon Merrick is? Or why he hates you?
I know exactly who Damon Merrick is. Start over and tell me everything. Did you and Rachel try to contact Sarah? I'm not going to chastise or blame you, Chloe, but I need the whole story.
So, I got my dealer to meet us, since he knows Sarah.
Frank Bowers.
Yeah, that's right. But Damon showed up with him.
What did Merrick want?
He asked us why we were so interested in Sarah.
And what did you say?
Nothing. Of course.
Is that how it became violent?
When he found out Rachel was the DA's daughter, he wanted information about you.
And how did he know that I'm her father?
I don't know. Maybe he's seen her before.
What happened next?
Damon had a knife out, and we all could see it. But then he said something that pissed Rachel off. And she just grabbed a piece of wood and hit him. And then he stabbed her. I keep thinking that maybe I could have done something, but when he attacked her, I just froze.
It's not your fault.
And Frank held him off so we could get to the truck. I heard a scream, but I don't know what happened. And then we were here.
I appreciate you telling me the truth.
What are you going to do about Damon?
Find out if he is alive. First of all, my department's been after him for some time. I was told that if Rachel had arrived only a few minutes later, she might not have, Thank you, Chloe. You saved my world. It will be some time before Rachel wakes up. I promise. I'll let you know when she does.
Okay. Thanks.
We're gonna stay right here.
Hey, Steph. How's Mikey? Pretty good. Miss Amber just told me Rachel's going to be okay.